What's up, y'all? It's me, Nikki, Torian Goddess, coming in with a quick message. This is a message for fire signs, Aries. I was just told to give you guys a message. Let's see what's good. I am shuffling the energy seekers. This message is meant to give you some clarity and some guidance. If you must seek medical attention, do that. Do not rely on tarot. It's about your spiritual awareness and your journey, letting go of any karmic attachments, any addictions is what I'm hearing. And I'm hearing something about toddlers. I'm hearing something about toddlers. Let's see what's good. See what the energy seekers got to say. Take what resonates and leave the rest. Understanding something is what I'm hearing. Understanding something. And it happened while you were riding. While you were driving through your neighborhood, while you were on your way to or from work, while you were on your way to the store, whichever you were in traffic. So, Aries, I'm seeing about what it is that you've been thinking about as far as religion is concerned, what you are believing, and what it is that your counterpart is believing. You both have formed your a different bond, a different belief system, whether it's power of the mind, metaphysics, or not being religious at all. There's something going on. I see a Cancer, a Libra, a Scorpio, and not doing too much. It's about what you're doing though, and it's going to take some hard work. It's going to take a lot of hard work is what I'm hearing. Those thoughts that you were having in traffic about improving your life, your lifestyle, and making your journey easier. Yep, you're thinking too much is what the G's is saying. And it's like you're tapping on a microphone, trying to be heard. You know, tapping on a microphone, trying to be heard. It's some confusion I'm hearing that needs to really be topped off is what I'm hearing. It's like it's a puzzling, difficult, it's like a difficult problem, and the accomplishments like I'm hearing something about what you're qualified to do, what you're qualified to do and what you're not qualified to do. So we're gonna see what's good. Twins. Someone may have twins, be expecting twins. You may be a twin, Aries, or you may feel as though you have met your twin flame. Cancer, Libra, and Scorpio is involved. Or those could be placements in your chart, your birth chart. Check your natal chart. for those placements. See what houses they fall in. Your planetary alignments. I'm also seeing some rap tunes. You could be in this traffic listening to some rap. Some old school rap. I just heard Dos Effects. Dos Effects. Let's see. Karma is a bitch. Period, point blank, isn't it? Especially when we are trying to transmute negative energy and when we're trying to move along our journey without any issues, without any negativity, and, you know, trying to leave people alone is what I'm hearing. Needing to leave some people alone as well. You got a fake friend around you, someone who's been conning you. Yeah, a fake friend around you who's been conning you, Aries. This could be the Cancer, the Libra, or the Scorpio. Take it how it resonates, but there's a lot of funny movements going on with people. A lot of funny movements. And it's the way that you move. It could be the way that you walk. But it's also about your walk as well. Yeah, it's about your walk as well. And some sort of, I heard something about someone being inoculated. That's like a vaccine. That's like a shot. A shot. A shot for inoculation, you guys. Isn't that a shot? Like a vaccine or something? Some sort of serum? Right? That inoculation is something like what? Treating a disease? I heard something about an inoculation and I'm seeing this fake friend and karma is a bitch and you needing to have some caution. I'm seeing money as well. Some unexpected income. Some unexpected income. And I'm hearing spirits say, save it. Save it. Save it. I'm hearing blame it on the rain. I'm hearing blame it on the rain. This traffic. The roads could be wet. They could be a little slick. Need to drive safely. Blame it on the rain. This karma. Could be facing a lawsuit. Could be facing a lawsuit. This con artist energy, it has a lot to do with money. It has a lot to do with money. And the G said it is what it is. Period. It is what it is. Let's clarify this twins card with some tarot. They said don't take those. Page of Swords. Three of Swords. Page of Swords and the Three of Swords. This twin. So it's like a hesitation. A hesitation to end something. It's like you're hesitating, Aries. You feel secure in this relationship, but you haven't done enough research, is what I'm hearing. You don't know this person well enough. You may feel drawn to this person, but this person is still confused themselves about why this relationship is taking place at this point in time in their life. Who is this fake friend? Six of Swords reverse. This fake friend, right? This Six of Swords reverse is about resistance, right? It's about resistance, and it's about someone not favoring someone, is what I'm hearing. Maybe not being a favorite. Someone who took the time out, or had to go in time out, had to go to a corner, is what I'm hearing. Someone went to a corner. Someone went to a corner. Seven of Pentacles, Three of Pentacles. Someone went to a corner, their own corner of their earth, and put themselves up on a pedestal, wanting to be higher than you, is what I'm hearing. You have some people looking at you, but they're looking down on you. They're looking down on you, and they're looking down on you. Because of a whirlwind of bullshit, is what I'm hearing. A whirlwind of bullshit. And it has to do with some very disappointing energy. But this is a karma wheel that's spinning. You hear me? With this Three of Pentacles, it's what's known. It's what's been seen. And it's about what's been casted aside. What really has not been sealed. What hasn't been sealed. An inoculation. Three of Wands. Eight of Wands, what hasn't been sealed. Payments. Payments haven't been sealed, is what I'm hearing. Payments have yet to be sealed, and neither has that vial. Neither has that vial. Someone has two very large teeth in their mouth. Front teeth could be molars. Someone could have something going on with their teeth right now. This fake friend. sitting on their throne, actually sitting on their throne, high up, you know, they feel as though coming off of their throne at this present point of time, though, coming off of their throne at this present point of time to actually publicize something about you. It has to do with some money, and it has to do with what hasn't. It's like a John Hancock. I heard something about some unclaimed money as well, Aries. But I'm also hearing something that's in handwriting, but it hasn't been sealed. It hasn't been mailed out. Listen. There's a confession coming. There's a confession coming, and the G's want you to bring yourself up. They want you to, I heard something about your posture. They want you to bring yourself up. They want you to have your, they want you to get your chin off of your clavicle bone. Because you've been sleeping too much, is what I'm hearing. You've been sleeping too much, and you've shown up been sleeping on this energy around you. But you may be peeping it. You may be peeping it in traffic. Clarify this, Cancer card. Seven of Swords. Someone is very competitive, and they don't feel as though that you, are going to be able to even guess what it is that they are bringing to the table concerning you. Someone is being false. Someone is being fake. Someone is being fake. Someone is being fake as hell, and they are standing on faulty foundation. They have been lying. They have been lying. They've been lying about their commission. They've been lying about some commission. They've been lying about some money. They've been lying about some money. But it's like they have an attitude with you, and they want you to accept what it is that they give you. But it's like they're feeding you bullshit. It's like they're feeding you bullshit. Someone is actually scared about some results. Yeah, someone is scared about some results. It's a test. It's a test of your faith, but it's a test too. Kind of have you a little stressed out. But I'm hearing don't be stressed. I'm hearing, yeah, look, don't be stressed. The Magician. Strength card. Don't be. Because what you have on your side, and what you have on your side. it's about you alchemizing your energy too. And I heard something about alkaline water. It's about you alchemizing your energy, about you taking on a different role, and about you not thinking too much about what's on your side. Inoculation. I keep hearing that. You may have some congestion going on as well. I'm also hearing this offer. This offer. You may be dating someone who was a twin, or you may be dating a false twin, is what I'm hearing. But yeah, this is someone that you are very much so infatuated with, but I'm hearing that you've been false as well. You've kept a secret because someone has been, either you have kept this secret or the person that you're dealing with have, you're both keeping some secrets from one another, I tell you that. And it has a lot to do with sexual energy. A lot to do with sexual energy has a lot to do with, and someone's been lying to you about some money, about what they've been blessed with, because they don't feel as though you deserve a cut. I'm hearing something about surgery. I'm hearing something about surgery. Yeah. Something is under the microscope. Something is under the microscope. There's a cancer. There is a Cancer who is at the highest point of festivity because what has been kept from them, but they have stepped into their high priestess energy. This person is no longer looking or even, you know, trying to differentiate what is going on in their life. This person is actually not thinking logically, but they're thinking more from a spiritual side. They are, this person has put on their spiritual lenses and they haven't taken them off. They are in their high priestess energy and they have this inner knowing, this inner knowledge about some self-sabotaging movements. Not only that, but someone who is sabotaging a relationship. Someone has someone jumps out of a relationship, jumps into one, jumps out of one. I mean, you know, just a few days, within a few days. Within a few days, this person can be dating someone, they break up with them, in 3 more days, they're dating someone else. Yep. There's a lot of confusion about this present date. And that's all this person is a date, is what I'm hearing. Clarify this twins card. Five of Cups. Very much so infatuated with this person. But I'm hearing what it is that you're not paying attention to. Both worlds. This person's spirit man. your spirits are not compatible, your souls are not compatible, but your flesh is. There's supposed to be a balancing out of some energy with this person because they get what they want and they got you, and now they don't want to deal with you anymore. Yo, Jesus, like, what the fuck part of the game is this too? But I'm hearing like attracts like. That's the phrase I just heard. Like attracts like. Let's get some messages from your spirit guides. Some transformation messages. Whoever this person is, they're very egotistical. And it's about you being patient. The both of you have a very playful appetite when it comes to relationships. Not really serious, but, you know, just there for the feel-good energy. Take that how it resonates. Just there for the feel good energy. You are never alone. You have your spiritual team with you. Those are your companions, especially when you are supposed to be healing, is what I'm hearing. They're long running, and a lot of people who are whispering sweet nothings in your ear, they cast spells. And I'm looking at like attracts like as well. Death is an illusion, and you are never alone. It's a lesson that you need to be focusing on. And it's one that, keeps you responding as you do. It's a natural response, and it's because of grief, and they want you to acknowledge that, is what I'm seeing. Also, that it's like you can't escape the law. Karma is real, and you have to understand that. Someone, it's like you've been conning yourself, is what I'm hearing, with your thoughts, and being compassionate and attracted to whoever this person is that you're with. It's like they've been your day-to-day distraction, is what I'm hearing. Your day-to-day distraction. It's like they distract you and they lead you down a road of where you're always feeling like you're on a shit brick road. It's like it's a natural high for you to be connected to someone so closely, and it's because you know you fear being alone, is what I'm hearing, and your spiritual team is about to draw a line in the sand and give you some alone time. Yep. They about to give you some alone time. Because you've never been alone. But the good news is that it probably means that you're at that point now where your ancestors and your guides and, you know, Most High, really, period, point blank, feels like you've separated yourself from yourself to participate in somebody else's great adventure. You hear me? That's your message.